Well, when you get into the tour village, you always run into a few celebs. Can I say has been? Because you're now retired, Dan Martin. Welcome back to the Tour de France.
Yeah, it's nice to be back here again. You know, it's there's always a nice little buzz at the race, you know.
And so what's your role here? What are you actually doing? I see you've got a Tour de France shirt on with the organisation.
Yeah, so I'm one of the race ambassadors. So, just hanging out, basically, talking to guests and trying to explain and give a bit of insight into what it's like to be a bike rider on the race and explain the race. And I give a briefing every morning as far as what to expect during the stage, although my prognostic so far in the race has been absolutely terrible. You know, I mean, a race full of surprises so far. And it's, I think now the riders, a little bit of a barrier put up between the riders and the public, and especially, like, obviously, years ago, all the riders would be coming and hanging out in here with all the VIPs, and now that doesn't happen, you know. So it's nice to have guys like me around just to give a bit of insight.
And for you, it hasn't been that long. I feel like you were racing yesterday. Does it feel a bit like that for you? And now you're on the other side of the fence. Is it a strange feeling sometimes still?
Yeah, obviously, this is my second Tour de France, watching it from the sidelines, and it's gone so quick, you know. And you still want to be in there, you know. It's you've got a little bit of, it's the only race of the year that I kind of get that little itch to be like, it'd be really nice to be there. But then on the other side of it, I understand too well what it takes to be on that start line and what it takes to be in the front of the race. And yeah, I'm not missing that bit at all.
Okay, now final question, and I know it's early days, but we've got to ask this one word: who wins the 2023 Tour de France?
Vingegaard, I think.
Good tip. Enjoy your time.
Cheers, guys.